Good evening, folks. I'm Victor Maddox. I'm a member of the LSC board. I'm one of the three amigos, along with Robert Gray and David Hoffman, who served as co-chairs. I've served as chairman of the audit committee since 2010, where David serves as a member. You know, John said earlier that this is an important event, and he was right, of course, but equally as important is the fact that this is an important project. And I think it's an important project because it has the promise of making positive change for the lives of hundreds of thousands of people. Robert and I co-chaired the fiscal task force some years ago, and that was an important project because it facilitated the fiscal integrity of legal services, and to that extent, it laid the foundation for the kind of bipartisan financial and budgetary support that LSC is seeing today. But this project substantively has the potential to bring tremendous help to communities across the country and to thousands of people. So I want to thank you all, everyone who participated in the task force, who gave up hundreds of hours of your own time and traveled to Indianapolis and Louisville and other places. And I know that you're going to continue to help us go forward to make this a project that has that realizes its promise. So the real reason I'm up here is to introduce our next speaker, who is Michigan's 6th District Representative, Congressman Upton. He is co-chairman of the Access to Civil Legal Services Caucus. He's also a member and former chairman of the Committee on Energy and Commerce. Congressman Upton has been in Congress since 1987, and prior to that, he worked for President Ronald Reagan in the Office of Management and Budget. So it's my pleasure to introduce to you tonight, Congressman Upton.
Well, thank you. It seems like 1987 was just yesterday, so it is great to be here. And I have wonderfully prepared remarks that my staff is waiting for me to say, but I'm not going to say them. Sorry. I had the chance to listen to Susan Brooks. She's a very good friend, serves on Energy and Commerce. Joe, I know, is right behind me. His plane has landed, so if I speak long enough, he'll be here, but I don't know what the traffic's like on the 14th Street Bridge. But also following Brian, who's also a member of the Problem Solvers. It's a bipartisan caucus. I'm vice chair with Debbie Dingell, and she's supposed to be here a little bit later, too. She's in a leadership meeting, I know. But this is really personal to all of us. First of all, thank you. Thanks for the report. I had a chance to review it over the weekend. They gave me a draft copy. It shows how relevant this is. I would note that last year in the Energy and Commerce Committee, probably the most important issue that we dealt with was opioids. We passed more than 60 bills, all on a bipartisan basis, all signed by the president. Somehow we got them through the Senate, and they are beginning to make a difference, just like legal services does too. I'm one of those members a long time ago that stood up for legal services because I'm not a lawyer, but I saw firsthand what they're able to do. And for those that complained about that, and there were many, particularly on my side of the aisle, Republican, I said, why don't we reform it? And we did. And it's important that it stays funded. And I would note that the appropriation bill, we don't know where things are going to end up. But rather than having a pretty severe cut, there's actually a nice little increase, and I will continue to support it, particularly as the vice chair of this important caucus as well. But for opioids, it's personal. I lost a very close family friend who struggled with addiction for much of his life, and it was so sad to get the call when I knew that he didn't make it. After a couple of days after he was found dead. And as I look at our district, Southwest Michigan, the need is, as I talked, it was Police Week, and I rode with some of my officers in Kalamazoo and other places. I talked to many officers who have been able to save folks within our calm. But it is so addictive, and it is so easy to get into this country, and we really have to have a much better education effort to try and reverse the dramatic increases that we've seen. And we've made some progress, but this report, I think, will make some more progress. It is so important that you're here so that you can use the network that you have in your own community, in your state, to reach out to Republicans as well as Democrats and emphasize the importance of this work that's done so that we can then use it, not only to make sure that services are funded, but members have a better understanding of what, in fact, is happening on the ground. So I just want to say thank you. Thanks for allowing me to spend a little time with you. Thanks for your report. This is a bipartisan issue, as it should be, and we need to address it that way. God bless. Thank you.